Alright, today I am going to be telling you some stories about the true devourer, Philandor. He was supposed to be the first devourer. You must know that Philandor was actually not too bad. He was always controlled by the bile with his every action. People thought his eyes were just the way. People thought his yellow eyes just born that way, but that was the sign of Glasson's enslavement. Of that, Philandor don't have a chance but just to obey. Philandor wasn't a fighter like Merlin, so he couldn't fight the bile which consumed him and even his crocodile. And Shane? Well, Shane is more luckier than Philandor. The only thing that Philandor had his power back was when he died. Killed by Tembal, the leader of the Green Cloaks. He was actually the one who rode on Raz's back. And that started the tradition. He was in Nilo. So he needed to wear green to blend in. But he knew that Raza is always going to be getting everything. But the thing I don't understand is how can Conquerors trap Raza inside a cage. That's Cretaceous. How can you trap a great beast? Even the cage that Telem built was still broken, and Telem is way powerful than normal humans with bile-bonded creatures. How could they build a cage that even Raza with her sharp claws could? Raza was actually one of the great beasts, Cinder. She is supposed to be the stealthy one of all beasts. Even Brigand had to amuse of her stealth. Because of that, Raza is actually very great at hunting. And but Brigand don't have the strength of Cabal or Raza's stealth. He is still the best hunter. He works in a group and don't give up. With his great pack of 100 wolves, it is definitely fair. 100 wolves, you might think. Brigand is one of the more visionary ones. Even Mulop is one the best. Brigand could tell future. And once he knew what will happen. But But the strange thing is, why didn't he know about Feliandor? She could have visions, too. He could drown people with visions from the past, blind them, even with his own mind. So you might think, what a powerful great beast. But most what is Essex, great Essex, must be so fast that even Halloween can't catch up. But Halloween could turn the wind against her. But it ended up with Talon. Talon is like so... Guess what? You know I don't like Cabal or Koval, and even Talon. He didn't do anything to help them in the previous war. He just stand there, and once they all die, he just imprisoned them. Why can't he follow the direction of four of his siblings? Four vs. two. Four great beasts vs. two great beasts. It's technically three great beasts vs. two great beasts. But Koval and Gareth on their side. I don't know, but Koval killed them. Even me, Koval, his ugly face. I don't like Katoa too. Who's Katoa? I don't know. The one bonded with Koval, I guess. Then after that, everything began to change. The bad guys turned into good guys. The good guys turned into bad guys. We flipped over. The green cloaks turned into bad guys. And the conquerors turned into good guys. Shane turned into a good guy. Alvin turned into a bad guy. Because of that, people will always love great beasts. Let's see, what is the smallest great beast? You ask? Well, it's very hard to. I know the biggest. Think of great beasts as just ordinary animals. Which beast would be the biggest? Neither would be the smallest. Pandas are very big, with polar bears. The Essex, a jar falcon, is about this big. An eagle is about a little bit bigger. Newark could be very big too. So I think Essex could be the smallest. There's no great beast of a rat, is there? No. So you might think Essex, right? Essex is supposed to be Wait, was her shortness and everything? Yes. She's the biggest? I suppose a polar bear could be the biggest. A ape? Not as big as a polar bear, so I think this is it. Goodbye, see you next time.